another unit that I need the master control headgear from. So fairly quick. I'll take the screw off here. And I may have to release it from the other end, that's the only. Not if I can undo the screws from this end. So this one's just a mule I've been grabbing stems from and surviving. This also has a little clip on here that makes it not so easy to get back to the after. There we go. Out of the way. And the handle's in here. I need the handle as well. Okay, and slide this forward. Alright, I'm able to get it far enough to put these little, very tiny screws here. Cover the screws just in case, because I may need those on the new one. So. Really tiny. Wow. Sometimes these don't even need those little screws, as it has an anchor that this little anchor is under. I'll end up pulling the wheel off. For now, I'm just going to take this part as I don't care about it too much. Again, I'm just using this one for spare parts as I need. So. There we go. And this, you just kind of bend it at the correct angle, and then I'll get it out. I don't think I needed to take these screws out, so they're not important for the function of the rest of these guys. There's our master control. So looking at the next set of, this is the one that I'll be replacing, just dawned on me what those little tiny screws are for. So this deal catches on as a magnet, and what it does is it acts to support the head rail when it has these longer lengths, and they've just bent in a small little portion of the head rail so that it would catch this magnet. This way this center bar doesn't sag for the longer lengths. So that's the purpose of this little magnet slide. When you replace a master control like I'm going to be doing, you want to make sure you put that back. So we've got a couple things here to do this. We need to unhook this last. Sometimes you just push up right here and now we can unhook it. And when we want to put it back, we just slide it into place and it clicks back in. So I'm going to release it, start pushing up, a nice design. And now I'm going to take that top screw out right there and replace this. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to remove the screw here. Enough to get it done though, in theory. Slide that one off, and then we need to take off the little clip here. It sounds easy. Got a little clip that holds it on the end.
completely familiar with how that one actually comes apart. There we go.
Oh, it looks like it just pokes up into the center. They've drilled a hole,
and it's just a tab. It goes in the center of the control. So.
All right.
Not my favorite design on there, but that's okay. So here's the little magnet piece. I'm going to save that. And then here's our master control. I'm going to slide that over.
Now sometimes these break off to where you can replace the end piece. And maybe I could have on this one. I don't know. But I traded it out with a new one.
Not an all bad thing. So here's the new one. There we go. And now I'll slide this back onto the Here's our magnet. Ah, shoot.
And what I forgot is those little tiny screws, which we want so that they catch that magnet. So I got to put those back. Shouldn't be too difficult to do in place. Getting them out of my pocket will be the hardest part because they're so tiny. Here we go. I may have to take that thing back off there. This is too tiny. There we go. Okay. I think this will be faster in the long run than trying to do it up there. Yeah, and those just allow the magnet to clip on.
Okay, so once again, I'm going to take this here.
There we go. Just at the correct angle. Okay,
and now we've got the deal. Put this back over. There. There we go. Making sure the feet are under there. And we've got the magnet. Just like that. Clip on. Okay.
And back at our back end, we'll clip in the final deal here. And that's clipped. And back on this end, we should have the end cap. And I don't know if you can see, I think it's got that little hole through there. That's going to go through this deal
once we put this on. So, like that, rotate it to where the hole is visible. Push that up and in through the little hole. You know, it's really not critical, it's just once it's in place, it's going to be held in place, but it's just an extra deal. Oh, and push it on. There it is. Push it on and in. Okay.
Now we'll set the screw in the top.
Yeah. These will kind of speed up so that these meet up better. Okay. And now we need one, which I did not bring the one with me. Alright? Well, I'll just show you it working and I'll come back and put the one. Few more things to do anyway, so should work out just good. Here we go. Just going in at the correct angle. There we go. These are self-aligning vertical blinds, so it will straighten out these other ones that are out of step. Should bring those in line. Now everything's in line. Now we can test out the operation. We'll stop the magnet there. There we go. Nice new master control on the vertical blinds. Done deal.
A quick search of my YouTube channel, you should be able to find a bunch of material that'll be helpful to your maintenance needs, and links to tools and parts used in the videos can be found in the descriptions below.